Hey guys, in today's video, I'm gonna be sharing with you my comprehensive guide for getting a younger looking neck. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Andrea. I'm a board certified dermatologist. I would love it if you would subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit the thumbs up. It really helps my video out a lot. Make sure you stay tuned to the end of the video because I'm gonna share with you guys some fantastic products for getting a younger looking neck. Your neck is gonna be one of the first places that aging starts to show up because the skin on the neck is much thinner than other body sites and it sees a lot of environmental stressors. Number one, if you are not protecting your neck from the sun, what are you even doing? It is so important. As I said, the skin on our neck is much thinner, so those UV rays are really, you know, damaging the deeper layers of your skin. Not only the UV that you're exposed to throughout the day when you run errands and things like that, but when you're indoors, UVA, comes through the window glass and contributes to the destruction of collagen with time. So make sure that you wear sunscreen every single day and make sure you reapply it, including when you are indoors. It's really an important part of protecting your skin all over, including your neck. You also can employ sun protective clothing like a scarf, for example. Whether it be skin, hair, nails, or your physique, any aesthetic goal that you have constantly got to be checking up and critiquing your lifestyle habits. Make sure that you are getting 7 to 9 hours of sleep per night. That is what is needed to repair skin damage and for healthy collagen production in the skin. A lot of repair happens when we sleep, and poor sleep increases the number two thing you have to keep in check, and that is stress. When we are stressed out, stress hormones, namely cortisol, are high, and that impairs healing. Number three, you have got to stop smoking and stop drinking too much. Tobacco and excessive consumption of alcohol impair the skin's ability to heal, depletes the skin's levels of antioxidants that are supposed to be helping fight off free radical damage, and people who smoke and or drink in excess show more prominent signs of aging of the skin, including on the neck. Don't be a couch potato. Make sure that you exercise every day. Exercise is important for getting the blood flowing, for increasing circulation. It will improve delivery of growth factors to the skin that help with repair. Exercise also lowers inflammation throughout the body that would otherwise impair healing and age our skin and the rest of our body. And then, of course, your diet. Really important for any kind of aesthetic goal. Take a look at your diet. When it comes to skin, you want to reduce the consumption of processed sugary foods. Fried foods and like smoked or barbecued meats that are cooked at high temperature. Why? Well, these foods, they are high in what are called advanced glycation end products that do contribute to skin aging, and they are inflammatory. It's not to say that you can't eat these things, but just, you know, you don't want to subsist on those. I have a video on the best foods for building strong, healthy collagen. I'll link it down below in the description box. Beyond the food that you ingest, the beverages that you consume also can help support healthy collagen production and help with improving the look of aging on your neck. Coffee and tea are packed with antioxidants. Peak Tea has been my go-to brand for high-quality teas for years. This portion of today's video is in partnership with Peak Tea. I drink about 1 to 2 cups of their tea every single day. And what I love the most about their teas is that they're really easy to prepare iced. And instead of flavoring my water with like one of those popular water flavor enhancers, I much prefer to have a high quality tea instead. And it's just a really nice, delicious treat packed with polyphenols. Their sun goddess matcha tea has concentrated catechins like EGCG that can help with cellular health and for repairing cell damage from ultraviolet radiation and environmental stressors. Their matcha tea is 100% organic and it's ceremonial grade. And what's really cool about it is that they actually shade the matcha tree to allow for 35% more L-theanine in the green tea. This is so helpful. L-theanine is a compound within green tea that has a calming property and can help with stress responses and with coping with stress. Their electric turmeric tea is delicious. Turmeric, if you're not familiar, is wonderful for helping total body inflammation, but their tea is unique in that they actually use turmeric from Okinawa that has been fermented to enhance bioavailability. And the tea also has wonderful cinnamon and ginger, which are rich in polyphenols as well. I can't get enough of their hibiscus beauty elixir. It's packed with vitamin C to support healthy collagen production and repair of the skin and various skin healing processes. I also like having one of their teas in the evening after a meal. The ginger digestion elixir is particularly good because the ginger is helpful in aiding in digestion and promoting good gut health, which ultimately is really important for total body inflammation. The other tea I love having in the evening is their mint herbal tea. Oh, it's so delicious. It freshens your breath and it's got spearmint in it, which is anti-inflammatory and packed with antioxidants to support healthy, radiant skin. I know what you're thinking, why Peak Tea? There's so many other teas on the market. Peak Tea has a cutting edge cold extraction technology that allows for the highest concentration of nutrients and polyphenols in their tea. Peak Tea dissolves in seconds in hot or cold water, so there's zero prep. I love not having the tea bag, it's super convenient. The teas are triple screened for any potential contaminants like heavy metals, molds, or pesticides. There's zero fillers, there's no artificial sweeteners, sugars, or preservatives. You're just getting very high quality tea. They have over 20 delicious award-winning flavors. They've gotten 3 gold medals at the Global Tea Championship, and they have 15,000 five-star reviews. That's more than any other tea brand on the market. If you're on the fence, don't worry. Peak Tea offers a 30-day satisfaction guarantee, meaning if you don't like the teas, you can get your money back. I know a lot of you have been on the fence about springing for the Peak Teas for some time, and they hardly ever offer discounts. But you guys, I was able to score a discount for you all. If you click the link in my description box and use code Dr. Dray, you can get 5% off of your Peak Tea order. Definitely take advantage of it. They are delicious. You're going to love them. And they're packed with polyphenols to support healthy, radiant, glowing skin, including the skin of your neck. Beyond sun protection and your lifestyle, there are some just little habits you may be doing that are affecting the appearance of your neck. One of them is scrunching your neck down to look at your devices. It's called tech neck. This is a newer phenomenon, but we're seeing it a lot more these days because people strain to look down at their phone or their tablet or their computer, and that causes horizontal creasing of the skin of the neck that ultimately results in prominent wrinkles. So be very mindful of your posture when you are on your devices. And a real beneficial thing for me has been getting a laptop elevator for my laptop so I'm not scrunching my neck down. The other bad habit is spraying perfume on your neck. A lot of people don't realize this, but perfume has different compounds in it that actually, when exposed to UV light, can degrade and become very irritating for the skin and contribute to photoaging of the skin of the neck cumulatively over time. So instead of spraying perfume on your neck, spray it on your waist underneath your clothing. That way you can enjoy your perfumes, colognes, etc., without putting your neck at risk for irritation. When it comes to your skincare routine, do not forget to put your moisturizer on your neck. This is a very simple thing that you can start doing today that will make a huge difference in the appearance of your neck. Simply by improving the moisture barrier of the skin of the neck, it will improve the look of wrinkles and fine lines by adding hydration into the skin and plumping up and smoothing out those uneven edges, rough texture. And just by adding hydration in the skin through consistent use of a moisturizer and reducing water loss out of the skin, this can also just kind of help improve even the look of hyperpigmentation. Not necessarily getting rid of it, but through light scattering can make it look less noticeable. So don't forget to moisturize. Now, let's talk about ingredients that you might want to be using on your neck. One that I've talked about in many videos is peptides. Peptides are ingredients that help with skin hydration, and there's some data to suggest that peptides, namely Matrixyl, can get into the skin and help stimulate collagen production. The data on that is still in its infancy, but I do think it's compelling enough at this point to consider using a peptide cream, such as one that has Matrixyl in it. The other ingredient to use on your neck, or a family of ingredients, is antioxidants. Antioxidants, they may help in fighting off free radical damage that ages your neck. Antioxidants like coenzyme Q10, soy, niacinamide, these can help potentially fight off free radical damage. I say potentially because some antioxidants, they're not super stable, and whether or not they get into the skin is kind of variable. Vitamin C is very popular. That's another option as well, but you guys know from my videos that vitamin C is not the most stable thing in skincare products. But CoQ10, niacinamide, soy, these are very stable and low risk of irritation. So something you might want to consider incorporating into your skincare routine is an antioxidant product with these ingredients. All right, the next most popular ingredient that everybody wants to know about is retinol. Retinol is a fantastic ingredient for boosting up collagen production in the deeper layers of the skin and helping to remove some sun damage. Unfortunately though, because the skin on the neck is so thin, it's more prone to excessive irritation from retinol. That's not to say that you can't use retinol on the neck, you certainly can, but you want to be really, really conservative with it. And what I mean by that is you only need a small amount of retinol to the neck, and you don't necessarily need to use it every day. In fact, I would discourage you from using it every day on the neck, because cumulatively that can start to cause a lot of irritation that shows up all at once with redness and increased dryness and sensitivity. And that redness, increased sensitivity, and dryness also can put you more at risk for sun damage. So be very conservative. Try just using a tiny, tiny amount once a week, then maybe bump it up to twice a week, but I wouldn't use it more than that on the neck. You might also consider using a silicone wrinkle smoothing patch to the neck. Medical grade silicone, such as what is used in the treatment of scars, when applied to the skin, it actually can help in improving the look of wrinkles and fine lines temporarily by drawing moisture into the top layers of the skin, hydrating things up, plumping up the skin cells, and ultimately smoothing out the look of wrinkles and fine lines. This is something that you can do at home for a few hours. You can even wear them overnight. They also help in reducing water loss out of the skin, which, as a side note, is greatest at nighttime. So it's a good idea to wear these at night. If you can wear it all night while you're asleep, perfect. And they really can actually help quite a bit in smoothing out the look of wrinkles and fine lines. I know a lot of you guys who watch my channel, you're already doing many, if not all, of these things that I've mentioned up until this point. What about taking it up a notch? What is something else you can do? Consider investing in an at-home red light device or going to a dermatologist and having red light therapy. Red light actually penetrates into the skin and can help in improving collagen production and smoothing out wrinkles. I have videos explaining the benefits of red light from an anti-aging perspective, so check those out for sure. But red light is safe to use at home and it can be effective in smoothing out wrinkles and fine lines. Now, before investing in a red light device, make sure you have the time and drive to commit to doing it. If you don't use it, it will not work. If it sits in a drawer and you only do it here and there, it will not work. Red light is safe to use daily, and the more you use it, the more benefit you will see in using a red light device. But don't buy one because they're not cheap. Don't invest in one if you're not gonna use it. Who should not use red light devices? People who are on medications that make them more sensitive to light. And of course, if you have any photosensitive disease, then you would not want to use these devices. But otherwise, they certainly can help. You also may consider seeing a professional for intense pulse light therapy on the neck. IPL is a treatment that, unlike laser, actually emits a variety of wavelengths of light that penetrate the skin at variable depths and generate heat. And that heat can help destroy unwanted pigment. And so it can improve the look of like mottled hyperpigmentation on the neck. This treatment is not right for all skin types. People who have a deeper skin tone need to be very cautious with this type of treatment. So always see a board certified dermatologist for this type of thing to make sure that you are an appropriate candidate for it and that the photo aging that you actually have on your neck is, you know, gonna be something that IPL is going to address. But that's another in-office treatment that you might pursue. What about prominent sagging? Topicals are not going to do anything if you have saggy skin on the neck. Topicals are not gonna do it. Even retinol, not gonna do it, not gonna touch it. In office, there are some procedures though that can definitely help in tightening the look of saggy skin, namely ultrasound and radio frequency. These are not inexpensive treatments and the results are variable. But that would be another procedure to pursue, namely for a saggy neck. Injectables in the neck are going to provide temporary benefit. And by injectables, I mean neurotoxin like Botox can help in smoothing out wrinkles. And then of course there's filler. You may be an appropriate candidate for that depending on the nature of the aging in your neck. In my opinion, one of the best in-office treatments for really rejuvenating the neck is going to be a resurfacing laser treatment. This can help improve skin texture, hyperpigmentation, smooth out the skin, smooth out wrinkles. There is some downtime associated with it, but it's definitely, in my opinion, one of the best bangs for your buck, if you will, as far as in-office procedures. What about surgery for the neck, like a neck lift? That is definitely an option, but you guys, you know, I don't know, over the past decade, so many new minimally invasive cosmetic procedures have come out and become available, new technologies, that you may not even need a neck lift or, you know, a neck surgery to substantially rejuvenate the look of the neck. And in fact, many of these minimally invasive procedures, they give a more, say, natural look as opposed to surgery. But surgery is certainly an option. All right, you guys made it this far in the video. I'm gonna share with you some products that I happen to think are really good for rejuvenating the neck. All right, I mentioned peptides and I mentioned retinol. There's actually a product that I have reviewed for you guys in the past that I really like. It is a combination of a retinol and Matrixyl. That's that peptide I mentioned that has been shown to improve collagen production. It's by number 7. So this would be a good option. Again, use it conservatively on the neck. And this is something that can definitely help in improving the look of wrinkles and fine lines on the neck, and also can help in removing sun-damaged skin cells and hyperpigmentation. You have to use it for a while to appreciate those changes, and they may be pretty modest, but it's definitely worth pursuing. As far as over-the-counter retinols, this product is not super expensive, and it is a potential option. I have another video on my top retinol products, so check that out. You know, the Neutrogena Rapid Wrinkle Repair Regenerating Cream would also be a great option. It doesn't have Matrixyl in it though, so I wanted to bring out the number 7 one because I think it's, you know, another potential option here that you may be interested in. All right, another product is a moisturizing product that is a kind of a lightweight liquid by Sana. This is a Japanese brand, and this product has fermented soy in it, which is rich in antioxidants and can really help brighten up the look of hyperpigmentation, and it can help in improving skin elasticity. So this is a very low risk thing for you to use on the neck. The beneficial compounds within the soy can kind of help with rejuvenating the skin of the neck, and then you're getting enhanced moisturizing from this product that will ultimately help with skin hydration. Another product though that I recently finished up, I love this. It doesn't get enough love. It is the Eucerin Q10 Anti-Wrinkle Cream. Q10 or coenzyme Q10 or ubiquinone is an antioxidant that has quite a bit of data behind it to support its use for topicals, for improving some of the visible signs of photoaging. It can inhibit that enzyme tyrosinase that leads to hyperpigmentation. It can help support collagen and elastin production. And unlike things like vitamin C, it's actually very stable, and you don't have to worry about it compromising the stability of other active ingredients. And so it's a very low risk thing to use. I like this product. The Inky List also makes a Q10 serum that's pretty good that I've reviewed for you guys in the past. So I'll link that one down below as well. Now, a product that I was not expecting that much from, I don't know why, because this brand always delivers excellent products, but I was just like, whatever, is the Dermatology Age Reversal Neck Cream. This is a moisturizer with peptides. I think it has, it's got Matrixyl in it, I wanna say. And I definitely see a wrinkle smoothing effect with this product. I mean, it's actually pretty noticeable. As a side note, you can use this as a facial moisturizer too. I've used it that way, but it's marketed as a neck cream, and it really does smooth out neck wrinkle, you know, fine wrinkles on the neck and just kind of textural irregularities. It really does give a nice luminous glow to the skin of the neck, and just kind of, it's a good everyday moisturizer that, again, you can use it on your face, take it down to your neck. Highly recommend this one. All right, and then as far as the silicone patches I talked about, CO is a brand that I am most familiar with. This is their chest patch that I have here. I couldn't find my neck one, but they make one for the neck. Now, people always ask me how to put it on with other skincare products. You really don't want to put it on top of your other skincare products because it might not adhere properly. And depending on the skincare product, it could make it more irritating. So the way I have always used these is I'll do my skincare routine in the evening, and then like an hour or so afterwards, I'll put the patch on. By that point, the products have absorbed, the skin is dry, so it's typically fine. And so I have had good success wearing these overnight and seeing marked improvement in smoothness of the skin the following morning. And it lasts all day and, you know, into the next evening. It's temporary, but I do see benefit with those in terms of just improved hydration. I like wearing them at nighttime as I sleep because, again, that's when water loss out of the skin is greatest, and I find they yield the most dramatic results when I do them. And you can reuse them multiple times, which is great. I mentioned red light, a product on the market that I would definitely recommend for anybody who's considering investing in a red light device for the neck is by Omnilox. Omnilox makes a face mask as well, red light face mask, but they came out with one for the neck that extends for the décolleté and chest as well. Omnilux is a fantastic brand for LEDs. I mean, they have a long-standing track record of light-based energy devices that we use in office, and now they've come out with some devices for the consumer to use that are really, really good, and their products are FDA cleared, so that's a good thing in an at-home device. I just really, really trust Omnilux. Over, you know, it's hard with these, with at-home devices, it's always hard. They're not regulated, and so it's hard to know if you're actually getting the appropriate wavelengths, if the device is actually made in such a way that you get good penetration of the light to the skin. This product is very good. It's not inexpensive, so again, don't buy it if you're not gonna use it every day. But if you're motivated to use it and you're doing all of the other easier things, like, you know, not smoking, although that is not easy. If you smoke, that's hard. But think about it. If you quit smoking, then you can afford the, you know, you can invest in the Omnilox. Okay. Yeah, but if you've done some of the other things, like you're doing sun protection, you know, everything else, and you're motivated to go the extra mile, I think it's worthwhile personally, the Omnilox device. I'm not affiliated with Omnilox in any way, shape, or form. I only recommend it because I know you guys want a recommendation for an at-home device, and that's the one that I feel the most confident in and have the most trust in, is the Omnilox one. Also, I'll link my laptop elevator down below too. For those of you trying to fight off tech neck, that can really help a lot as well. I mean, it's made a huge difference for me. I'm not scrunching my neck down quite as much. So that is my comprehensive guide for how to get a younger looking neck, but don't feel as though you have to like jump on all of these tips and strategies today, all at once, go all in. Start with some of the things I mentioned first, the lifestyle factors for sure. Please focus on those lifestyle factors first and foremost. And of course, please, please, please focus on sun protection. Those two things alone will make a huge difference. Just doing those two things alone will make such a substantial difference in the health of your skin and then your total body health that, I mean, you may not even need the rest of this. If you're smoking and you quit smoking, you start doing all of these other things that I mentioned, diet, exercise, better sleep. You know, once you quit smoking, you do end up sleeping better because it keeps you up at night. Anyways, once you start doing all these things, you'll probably forget about the red light device. You'll probably forget about fractional laser, you know, CO2 laser, resurfacing laser, the expensive stuff. You might actually just be happy at that point. So do the lifestyle things. They can make the biggest difference in everything. All aesthetic goals, and including, you know, the look of your neck. And then of course, sun protection is key for prevention and maintenance of the look of the neck. Don't forget, check out Peak Tea, you guys. You can get 5% off using my link in the description box and code Dr. Dray. And I hope you all enjoyed this video. If so, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and as always, don't forget, sunscreen and subscribe. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Bye.